Following the recently hailed protest by tanker drivers and the fuel shortage that hit most of Lusaka's filling stations, some concerned stakeholders are calling on government to consider re-strategizing and putting measures in place so as to avoid similar occurrences in the near future. Opposition political party, National Restoration Party leader Steve Nyerenda says there's need for government to put Zambians' interest as first priority. Mr. Nyerenda explains that the recent tanker drivers' wrangles is as a result of government disregarding Zambian transporters and favoring the foreigners.
Yes, it's very, very unfortunate. But first of all, this is what we talk about. We talk about Zambia is for Zambians, and only Zambians will develop this country. We say that if Zambians are given the tools, if Zambians are empowered, if Zambians are given all the necessary capacity to do the job, they will do the job. Now, these are the Zambians. Some of them, they own the trucks. Some of them, they're drivers. Some of them, they have borrowed money to make sure that they do the business. But the business is not being given to Zambians. The business is being given to foreigners. And this is what is causing the problem. But nevertheless, I also talk about the leadership. I'm saying the leadership with the vision. Vision in terms of the economy. A vision with the economy, which is goods and services that are produced. Goods and services that are distributed, the distribution of goods.
He says Zambian citizens have the potential to develop the nation if only accorded with a chance. Meanwhile, non-governmental organization, the Continental Leadership Research Institute Executive Director, Mundia Harola, says there's need for government to put in place measures that should address storage of fuel for future usage.
To us as an institute, we take this opportunity to call upon the government of the Republic of Zambia to ensure that we create systems that will ensure that at a time when there is a distortion or disruption in the supply chain of fuel, we have a way in which we can counter or cushion these disruptions by ensuring that we have adequate storage, at least for even a month, so that the disruptions do not affect the economic activities of the country. It is important that even in the COVID era where we are, we create proper systems that are going to ensure that at a time when we are going to have disruptions in the supply chain, we are prepared adequately to ensure that we counter the disruptions by our preparedness in having enough fuel in our storage capacity, in our storage facilities.
Both men were speaking to Movie TV News in Lusaka on the 5th of April, 2021. Reporting for Movie TV News, Namangolwa Mundia.